muscle tissue, and nervous tissue. Skeletal muscle attaches to bones, allowing for voluntary movements of the body. 40% of your body mass is made up of skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscles generate heat as a byproduct of their contraction, and thus participate in thermal homeostasis. For example, shivering is an involuntary contraction of skeletal muscle in response to a perceived lower than normal body temperature. Such shivering generates heat and raises the internal body temperature, returning it to normal. The muscle cell, or myocyte, develops from myoblasts that are derived from the embryonic mesoderm. Under a light microscope, muscle cells appear striated or striped, with many nuclei squeezed along the membranes. These striations appear due to the regular alternation of contractile proteins. The contractile proteins in skeletal muscle are actin and myosin. Muscle cells are multinucleated as a result of the fusion of many myoblasts that fuse to form each long muscle fiber. Cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle forms the contractile walls of the heart. The cells of cardiac muscle are also known as cardiomyocytes. Cardiomyocytes appear striated or striped under the microscope. The cardiomyocytes are single cells, typically with a single centrally located nucleus. A unique property of cardiomyocytes is that they are able to contract on their own, creating intrinsic rhythms without any external stimulation. Cardiomyocytes attach to one another with specialized cell junctions called intercalated discs. Intercalated discs have both anchoring junctions and gap junctions. These allow the cardiomyocytes to form long branching structures that synchronize their contractions, causing the heart to beat under involuntary control. Smooth muscle tissue. Smooth muscle contractions are responsible for involuntary movements of internal organs. It forms the contractile components of the digestive, urinary, and reproductive systems, as well as airways and arteries. Each smooth muscle cell is spindle-shaped with a single nucleus and no visible striations. Nervous tissue. Two main classes of cells make up nervous tissue, the neuron and the neuroglia. Neurons propagate information via electrochemical impulses called action potentials. Action potentials are biochemically linked to the release of chemical signals. There are three main parts of a neuron: the cell body, the dendrites, and the axon. The cell body includes most of the cytoplasm, the organelles, and the nucleus. The dendrites are branching structures that come off of the cell body, appearing as thin extensions. Dendrites are specialized for receiving information in the form of neurotransmitters and other chemical messengers. The axon extends from the neuron body and can be wrapped in an insulating layer known as myelin or the myelin sheath. The second class of neuronal cells comprises the neuroglia or glial cells. There are a few types: astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, and Schwann cells. Astrocytes are named for their distinctive star shape. They are responsible for the regulation of ion concentration in the intracellular space. Astrocytes also perform the uptake and breakdown of neurotransmitters. Lastly, the astrocytes form the blood-brain barrier. The blood-brain barrier is a highly selectively permeable membrane that allows only very few substances to enter from the bloodstream to the cerebrospinal fluid, which surrounds the spinal cord and brain. The oligodendrocytes produce the myelin sheath for neurons located in the central nervous system, which includes the brain and spinal cord. Similarly, the Schwann cells produce the myelin sheath on neurons located in the peripheral nervous system. Thank you for watching.